for solutions elsewhere, all those mentioned above, whether for good or for bad, all of them, they stay to the community of the righteous. They never, for a moment, waver. Any rule, therefore, for the relatives. It is not uncommon for family members and relatives to constitute the actual trial, the main trial, or part of it. The case of Prophet Lot and Noah easily come to mind, as well as the role played by Abu Lahab, the uncle of Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This notwithstanding, it is expected that responsible family members and relatives will stand by the affected person during the time of need. The role of the wife and brother of the Prophet Ayub alayhi wasalam easily comes to mind. In an hadith narrated by Anas bin Malik, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasalam said, Allah's Prophet Ayub suffered for 18 years. I want to repeat. The Prophet Muhammad said, Allah's Prophet Ayub suffered for 18 years from affliction. I was shunned, stabbed by relatives and strangers alike, besides two men who were closest of his brothers to him. So it is therefore issues, it is a thing that an occurrence that has been happening right from the beginning of time for people to run away from you when there are problems. So it happens to Ayub alayhi salatu wasalam. Whenever he went out to answer the call of nature, after he might have finished, his wife would take his hand, but he came back home. But one day, it took a longer time. And Allah had revealed to Ayub alayhi salatu wasalam. Ayub alayhi salatu wasalam, as captured in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Fusal, that is chapter 38, verse 42, Urkun bi Rijli. Hadha muqtasilu baridu wa sharab. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, strike the ground with your feet. This is a spring of water to wash in, cold and refreshing drink. She, the wife, turned to look at him. As far as Allah has taken away the afflictions after the revelation he has been suffering from, and he looked better than ever. And then Allah sent two clouds, and when one of them reached the threshing floor of wheat, it rained gold until it was full. The other rained silver, and then the barley threshing was also filled. That was how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replenished everything that had been taken away from Ayub. But it was two of his brothers and the wife who stood by him in his own time of need. And that is why the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Fusal again, chapter 38, verse 43, Allah again said, "Wa abna lahu wa alahu islamum ma'hu rahmata minna wa dhikri li ulil albab," meaning, I'm giving back his family, and along with them, the light thereof as a mercy from us and a reminder for those who understand. Therefore, do not abandon your brother, your sister, your relative who are in need. We should not abandon them. So, if it is in the case of comfort, it's easier when it is the what we consider as bad. But in the case of comfort, when your brother is making it, but is no longer following the path, you say, don't let me offend him, because he's not going to take care of the children. Don't let me offend him, because he's going to become annoyed. I want to call your attention again to chapter 66, verse 6. Here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O anfusakum wa alikum nara wa hukudu anasu wa ijaratun alaya malaikatun gilasun sidadun la yasuna allaha ma amaram waya faluna ma yumaru. Believe, or you will believe. Water from yourselves and your family. A fire whose fuel are men and stone. Over which are appointed angels. Stand and severe. Who is the leader from executing the command they receive from Allah? For do that which they are commanded. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, La yakhudul janna al-qatil. La yakhudul janna al-qatil. The meaning there is, one who suffers long time shall not enter paradise. Let me repeat, the one who breaks the family ties will not enter paradise. So we should be close to them. Any role for the Muslim community, I want to take the hadith of the Prophet. Again, the Prophet said, you will see the believers in their mutual kindness, love and sympathy, just like one body. When a limb complains, the whole body responds to it with willfulness and fever. In another hadith, the Prophet has said, the believer is for one another, and for another believer, like a building, some of which strengthens the other, then he intertwines his fingers. There is no exaggeration. If I observe here that brotherhood is at the lowest hell, it is a brotherhood that has meaning when assistance are required from one or the other, and perhaps sentimental when any evil befalls. There is the need for an improvement. I'm able to say that many of us today do not know where we reside any longer. Too bad. This calls for a serious redress by the welfare directory, if it still exists. If the directory still exists. If it doesn't exist, we all need to make effort to address it. Which is therefore the way forward? There is the need for all to accept that triumph are the very essence of our active sojourn. That the rule is for trial, right or wrong, bad or good, to happen. That's the rule. And of course, I think I've been able to give you verses from the Quran to justify this. So I said, there is the need for all to accept that trial are the very essence of our active sojourn. Two, that the first and the best instrument is to be constantly patient. Hear the Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter 2, verse 45, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Wasta'inu bi sabri wa salat wa innaha lakabiratun illa alal khashi'in. Meaning, and seek help in patience and with prayer, and truly, please note this, with patience and prayer, Allah now said, and truly, it is extremely heavy and hard, except for the true believers and those who have submitted themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The above should be accompanied with prayer, patience first. But you should also pray. We don't want to go into the stories of some of the prophets, why it has taken a longer time. Yes, you must be patient when Allah is coming with good or the bad, but you must also pray. And we saw those on either side of the divide, they pray. The Almighty Allah continue to accept our prayer. The need for constant reminder and admonition, I think I mentioned that earlier, cannot be overemphasized. Because the Prophet has said, help your brother if he's doing what is good, and help your brother if he's doing what is bad. He said, as for helping our brother doing what is good, we can understand. But how do we help our brother doing what is bad? He said, by ensuring that we stop him. And the Quran has said, Wata'awwanu ala al-birri wa taqwa wa la ta'awwanu ala al-ithmi. What could man? The conclusion I therefore want to draw. If Prophet Yusuf, alayhi salatu wa salam, did not dream. Perhaps he would not have thrown, he would not have been thrown into the well. If you are not to face the challenges in the well, perhaps those that sold him to the household in Egypt would not have discovered him. If you are not to be in Cairo, perchance Suleha would not have tried to seduce him. If it did not become the talk of the town, maybe he might not have gone to the prison. If he did not go to the prison, perhaps he would not have met with the two prisoners. And if he did not interpret the dreams for the two prisoners, perhaps he would not have become the minister in the foreign land and saved his people from hunger and starvation. We should therefore stop crying for having no shoes. After all, there are people without legs. Yet, they have not in the least offended Allah. So, Nahu, Wada Allah, rather, trials and tests are to bring the best or the worst out of us. He is the most successful who has used trial to fulfill the will of Allah. And the worst of being is he who through trial has completely missed the right way. So I am Rabbika, Rabbina, Rabbi is that you have my yasifun. Wa salamu ala al-Muslim. Wa alhamdulillahi, Rabbi al-Amin. Sallu ala al-Nabi al-Karim. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we thank Allah for his life. May Allah continue to bless him and continue to increase him in knowledge and iman. I'm wearing a very big cap today. Yabir is not around, so I'll try to see. I will shave the cap to my head. I can increase my head to fit the way it out. So I will attempt to do some summary, very brief. Number one, he defined the topic. He broke the topic into two, trials, punishment. He defined from the angle of the Quran. The next thing he did was to go to the question, the first question that we asked, which is trial punishment or blessing? He concluded that question saying, trial is a means to an end. Number two is the rule of life, and that the fact that trial is both positive and negative. He went to the next to say, what is our reaction to trial? If it is negative, we should be firm in our belief and pray. And in addition to our prayer, we should add our effort. If it is positive, we should not be arrogant and engage in self-praise. He went further to doubt on the role of relatives when trial comes. He said, if it is negative, the relative should not have to eat by saying, rather, they should act as a pillar to that person and encourage that person to match up. If it is positive, they should give good advice so that that person will not become arrogant. What is the role of Muslim woman? Is that that place that he gave us, that we are the lowest help. All of us research ourselves when it comes to this. That Muslim, you are not like the way the brotherhood used to be during the life of the Prophet. Whether good or bad, they are with each other. So we research this, and he gave us an assignment in companion, which is our welfare directory, that we should make sure that our welfare directory is up and doing. Way forward, he said, we should be patient with trial, and we should have constant reminder as condition. That is where this session and other sessions fix it. Those are the things I've been able to take from his lecture.
First of all, I want to thank Brother Abidjanil Abdelajid, who reminded me that I've not been attending this program for a long time. Even sometimes I used to be in Lagos. And I promised him that the next one I am in Lagos, I will attend. Hope I have fulfilled my promise. And so, please. pray for me that I will not be defeated. I have made you, all of you, a lot. I have only one Jama in Kaduna, only one place. That's Dr. Tabu. We spend all our time together every time we have the opportunity. So once again, to my brothers and sisters in Lagos, I say assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And in Okwana, in Okejia, that is here, that is here now. The first is about the subject of the law. The second is about our woman, what is going on. And the third is about our organization, the company. And third, from the first one, the subject of the law. The Almighty Allah himself, from what the man, the letter has told us, we are going to give you all the money. That's why we are not going to give you all the impact that we have done. We have created the genes and men that we have done to worship me and worship me alone. And they are not going to call me and they are not going to call us that we are also creating you into toiling, into struggling, into striving. So in our life, when we are worshiping Allah, because instead some of you and some of us are worshiping him, because of the gains and pains we are going to derive from him, we are therefore to remember that as we are also in the process of worshiping him, we are going to face trials and tribulations in our life, part of our life, part of the process of Allah. So when it comes, do not do the word, and then in the calling, is it me alone? Why me? Why did you be the tarot of Mr. Abaya? Why should it be? Why not you? Why not me? It can be anybody. When it comes, that is the time we want to test your decline. That is the time we want to test your sincerity of faith and belief in Allah. I'm watching that last month, they are giving me a good wife, and he said, good children, good dad, and good boy. Have you bought the tickets to go to Marcos or me? Is that which one that wants to be him? Of course, of course, I do that. And that's why when any little thing, adversity, good thing, you think going on about. Having sleep that night, I'm crying and wailing. That's the time we remember one show that when you have a show to say, and here and there, but I don't want to let us know that part of our land is fire, when it comes, it is a fire on the part of the land. The only thing about Allah will say that when you are hungry, there are two ways out for you. Anywhere that comes, they are down to the land. Give land food to quench your hunger, they are down to the land. To be honest, there is no better life you want to live than to break on, get the healer of this world and go there and join it. The second one is about our movement. This permits me. And I'm happy to lie that the program is coming to address that. Many of us standing here before this day, we have been managed for decades. I'm not even counting years again. We are doing 3 decades, 4 decades, 30 years, 40 years of marriage. And we all marry from the same community of evidence. And I think I have found one of our members. I start to recall, maybe you can remind me, one of our members that have divorced his wife. I start to recall. In fact, instead of divorcing, we have added one or two or three. Yes. No more, but that's my mind. We are adding instead of reducing. But what happened in the past few years? A few, a little 5 years ago, I can count number one, number two, number three, number four, 5 years marriage that I'm putting down about the youth, about our children. What has gone on? Is it the protest that they're producing these bad products? But to me, it's a failure of we are not for. The money is retired, we should not be enjoying the food of our labor. You are, these people are our children. What happened? What did we do wrong? Or what are they doing wrong? We need to sit down and do a study. Why are young managers breaking down?
1 minute.
1 minute. We need to do that. The final one everybody glory. But I hope what I've started in and it took place, and I hope that we will have to take it up again. We must have our own national territory and our own territory. We cannot be patching like a bird. We can't. And then I look around, we are not poor, we are not standard. We will not be rich, like when I am talking to you today, we are not rich, but we are not poor. And we don't know whether or not that even that bandits, they are shite. Your charity is not affecting your wealth. They are in that bandits, in poverty, they are shite. Why? Because up to today, we cannot take it with our pain. And when I have the money, don't think that we are working for Shogun. I won't take Shogun. We are not going to take Shogun for our. I won't take it. Because as far back as 1992 or 90, we started from the same Shomodu, and we left Shomodu when I was there new. So we can't go back to Shomodu. If you want to go there, it wouldn't mean that not then it's a pretty place for us. As we have asked there or Kenya, then we are afraid. Whatever money we have, we are afraid. The only reason we are going for our own personal well-being. We must pray for the woman. We are taking two steps. This is not how we started. And I will not take it, and I hope that all of you are listening to me, whatever we are going to do, we must do it. This is the way we vote from 5 years of that school. I will give it, I will buy it. That this is not your vote. This is whatever you put before Allah, Allah will do for you. Which we have today, let God get that 3 or 4 million Naira today, this morning. And that is what we do. Because we thought that we should make the place a befitting center. And I like that you people are bringing your people to me. The God befits me, the God befits you.
I just want to mention to two or three points that were indeed emphasized by the lecturer on the topic of this. One, that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inflicts us with trials, what are we expected to do? And indeed, before then, he made mention of the fact that trials and tribulations are indeed the rule of man. But how prepared are you and I to play by the rule as we normally reiterate? Then one of the points is when we are inflicted, one, we should be patient. When we are inflicted with whatever to be tied to this analogy or unpalatable growth, we should be patient. That's number one. Then number two is that we should have a faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we should not be forgetting. And indeed, when we are tried by Allah, please, the only criterion which Allah uses to measure your own iman and my own iman is trials and tribulations. If you rush through some of the verses that the lecturer put there for us, it is only when you are tried. The essence of trying, as Allah said, is that surah to Baqarah he quoted, is indeed to prove to us how truthful, how steadfast you are with the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this idea, the very lesson that I want us to take home. And on the last note, the moderator mentioned about the ongoing legislative process. So please, compare us as an icon. We should just try as much as possible to always be in the forefront of being proactive when it comes to legislation. And this is a fundamental aspect of our faith. When you scroll around, we know the Islamic thing. So I want to discourage the liberal effort that should be collective and coordinated effort so that it will have more weight. So we are going to move the thing to Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum. I have two questions. One is the topic of today, another one is the general question. The first one is whenever a Muslim loses somebody and that person is a woman, and that person is trying to show a level of iman by maybe after she has lost a child, for example, and by 2 o'clock she goes ahead to meet her ketu to perform ablution and to start for her. And she has refused to cry just because of the lectures and everything she has listened to. But from family members, now regard that person as maybe she's a witch and she's the one that has killed her son or daughter. And in that place, maybe they have been told to cry. They should not share tears. In this case, how do we educate the public that when a Muslim loses a child, that person should show high level of iman? Number one. Number two is, well, if somebody is owing somebody a certain amount of money, and you are trying to gather that money to pay the person, but somebody now asks you that you should please give him something, can you give out of that money you are accumulating to pay your debt, or you leave that person that is in need and face the debt?
Okay, next question.
My question, thank you very much for the work put together lectures, just as a reminder for a lot of us, not all. The question about the trial and tribulation. I just want us, the lecturer, to relate it to the Quranic ayah or the saying that any trial you go through serves as kafara for you. And then, of course, the Quran that says in Amman, because true, it may be said, but maybe quite difficult and difficult in most families. So, just the clarification on this.
Family like this, in fact, they are only a dear woman. They are dead in the court, a dear woman. So, and this one there, the word of the Prophet Muhammad, and the Prophet inquired, did you have a relationship over the night? And he said yes, and the Prophet prayed that Allah would bear that particular thing. So what is expected from the starting point of view is that you do not mind which one, the role of the community is that we should continue to place like this, so that we know there are so many things that happen in our environment that doesn't, I mean, I give you another one. If a woman should walk to a man, I love you, I want to marry you, in this environment, what would we say? Yes, a woman did that during the time of the Prophet Muhammad, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. We therefore, it is our duty to ensure that we let people realize that after all, there was nothing wrong with what that woman did. And that it is in line with the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. But as to what to do, we will continue with our enlightenment program so that we let people know. Otherwise, there is no alternative. But to those of us who are here, the question you should have asked yourself is, if a mother has killed a child, to whose benefit? For whose benefit? At any rate, if you also want that to happen, you pray that will happen to you. We should not allow sentiment. More often than not, it is sentiment that what will people say. But this what has happened in time with Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that has been mentioned, and we should now ensure that we allow so many people to be aware of the fact that the woman was not adjured, but merely accepting what has happened to her in good faith and as a Muslim. After all, the tears and the demonstration cannot bring back the child. So, as Muslims, what the woman has done was right, but the community should endeavor to be around the woman, support her, and endeavor, allow people to know that what she has done is the right thing. You are in debt, and somebody else is in need of money. You are not the owner of that money. that money belongs to somebody else. So you cannot take from money that doesn't belong to you and then you give to another person. It's not your money. The money belongs to another person. So do not take from the money which you want to use to send to your debt to help another person. Of course, we see that happen during the time of the Prophet, but we have said it here that because what we have seen happen during the time of the Prophet is friend A will go, a brother A will settle the debt of B without settling his own. And B will also settle that of the brother A without doing his own. But as we have today, we need to build on that. So the money that has been given to you as loan is to settle your loan first before you are you assist you do sadaka. Trial, sickness and kafara that is alleviated is remove the sins, is remove, yes, it is true. No doubt about that, but then that is for those who acted the street the way they should be acted. If, for instance, when you have it, when one is undergoing trial, you comport yourself in line with the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad, Salah alayhi wa salam, that was what Allah said, Ulaika alayhi salawatu min Rabbi. That the blessings of Allah is going to be on you. And that also, in fact, find a man who is in Yusra for that corroborate that position. That with every difficulty, at the end of the day, you will end up in the comfort. So for those who do not comfort themselves, for those who instead of following the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they started going to Babaye Biwo. Then you don't expect any reward because your reward is where you have gone. Because you do not believe that Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala is the one that has taught it and is also the one that will remove it. Wallahu Adam. So you add the video to this.
Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The next thing is that we're going to listen to two of our brothers on issues that bordered on Moswin.
This is just a way of announcement on the Muslim Women of Southwest Nigeria. The organization, all of us, and it's the process of expansion because of the growth. So they are trying to improve on three positions. Corporate service manager, finance officer, and programs project officer. The corporate services manager is like an office manager. So issues relating to administration, corporate meetings, liaising with member organizations, and so on and so forth, are what that is all about. So if there's someone who is very interested in going